Hi friends, my name is Anakin Lalwani and today we're going to be doing Let Us Use the Graticule from Geography, Standard 6, Chapter 2. And we're also going to revise from Chapter 1, Earth and the Graticule. So first, let's see what are latitudes and what are longitudes. So, longitudes are vertical lines connecting the two poles. And latitudes are horizontal lines that are parallel to the equator. So, what is the equator, you must be asking? The equator is an imaginary line that divides our planet into a northern hemisphere and a southern hemisphere and has a latitude of zero. As you know, horizontal parallel lines with varying curvatures are called latitudes. Each degree has a latitude, like the equator with 0 degrees and then the 1 degree latitude, 2 degree latitude, 3 degree latitude, and so on till 90 degree latitude on both the hemispheres. So to identify which latitude we're talking about, we'll see how to identify them. So to identify a latitude lying in the northern hemisphere, let's take an example of 10 degrees. To identify if it's in the northern hemisphere, we have to say 10 degrees north. And to see if in the southern hemisphere, we have to say 10 degrees south. As you know, each degree has its own latitude. And there are 90 latitudes in both the hemispheres. So using this knowledge, let us now try to read maps. But wait, there's a problem here. We cannot locate a place on our globe with latitudes alone. So let's take an example of India and Cairo. They both lie on the same latitude of 30 degrees north. That is why we also need a vertical measure called longitudes. So before we go to longitudes, let's just revise what are latitudes. We call the latitudes parallels of latitude because they are parallel to each other. As you know, the shape of the Earth is circular horizontally. So we have a 0 degree line called the equator. The equator divides the Earth in equal halves or hemispheres, which are the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. And there are the same number of latitudes, parallels of latitude, in each hemisphere. There are 90 latitudes in the northern hemisphere and 90 latitudes in the southern hemisphere. And don't forget, each degree has its own latitude. Now we can go to longitudes. Longitudes are called meridians of longitude. The shape of the Earth is this oblate spheroid vertically. So we cannot divide it in equal halves vertically, right? So what is an oblate spheroid? An oblate spheroid is nothing but a geoid. A geoid is a sphere whose top and bottom are squeezed and the sides are bulging out. So the oblate spheroid or geoid has the top and bottom of a sphere squeezed inwards and the sides are bulging out. So Newton was the first person to propose Earth was an oblate spheroid or geoid in shape. So because of this, the world assumed a zero prime meridian, which passed through Greenwich, London. So they took it for convenience. So the vertical lines that appear vertical with varying curvatures are called the longitudes or the meridians of longitude. So now let's go on to global standard time, GMT. Greenwich Mean Time?
So you must be asking, what is this Greenwich Mean Time? That you'll get to know later on in the lesson. For now, let's just continue. So from the prime meridian, other meridians are marked east or west up to 180 degrees. Like the latitudes, we need to identify if the longitude is going from is in the east or it is in the west. So just like that, let's take an example of 30 degrees longitude. So to say if it's in the east, we say 30 degrees east, and to say if it is west, we say 30 degrees west. So now the prime meridian and 180 degree meridian lie opposite to each other. So as you know, the prime meridian, from the prime meridian, other meridians are marked east to west up to 180 degrees. The prime meridian and 180 degree meridian lie opposite to each other. There is another special longitude, the international date line or the 180 degree meridian. The international date line is marked with reference to this 180 degree meridian. So now that we know all about longitudes and latitudes, let's learn to read maps. So now let's try to pinpoint a location. So to pinpoint a location on the globe, we need to consider only one parallel and one meridian. So the example, let's take an example of New Delhi. New Delhi is located at 28 degrees 36 minutes and 50 seconds north latitude and 77 degrees 12 minutes and 3 seconds east longitude. So you will be asking, what is this minutes and what is this seconds? Don't confuse this with time, huh? Each degree or each latitude and longitude, each degree for latitudes and longitudes are divided into 60 minutes, and each minute is divided into 60 seconds. So using this, we pinpoint a location. There is another interesting fact. Today, most devices use this triangulation method using one latitude and one longitude to triangulate or pinpoint a location, which is called the GPS system. GPS is short for Global Positioning System. GPS is usually used by cars, aeroplanes, ships, and even mobile phones to pinpoint a location. The system of reading GPS in degrees, seconds, and minutes is called DMS. So this is method one of reading a map. To pinpoint a location, we use this method, the GPS method. So now we'll be looking at the world map. So here you can see the prime meridian, the longitude that passes through Greenwich. And there is the equator. And then there is the international date line towards the sides of the globe or the map. So now we'll be doing an activity. For that, we'll need to see Australia. We need to look into Australia. So Australia is in the southern hemisphere and towards the eastern part of the globe. So remember that for method 2. For understanding the extent of a region, we need to consider two parallels and two meridians at the extreme ends of the region. So this is method 2. We are going to be finding the extent of Australia. That is why I said we need to look into Australia, right? So Australia lies between 10 degrees 30 minutes south and 43 degrees 39 minutes south latitude and 113 degrees east
to 153 degrees east longitude. So as you can see, I've created a box around Australia, and then we measured their longitudes and latitudes to find the extent of this region. So this is method 2. So now let's go to method 3. To locate the linear features like roads or rivers, we need to consider the origin point, the start point in longitude and latitude, and end point, the mouth or the intersection point of the feature. So now let's see River Nile. So the extent of River Nile is 0 degrees 45 minutes south latitude and 33 degrees 36 minutes east longitude. That is the origin. As you can see in the smaller image over here, I have marked the extent. So you can see to this origin, to 31 degrees 12 minutes north latitude and 29 degrees 55 minutes east longitude up to the mouth, as you can see in that small image given there. So now, there is an interesting fact about the world's smallest country, Vatican City. It is spread over an area of 0.44 square kilometers. This country is located within Italy on the Italian peninsula. See the latitudinal and longitudinal extent from this country from west to east and also from north to south. In the small image in the center of the slide is given. And if you observe, there is no difference in the degrees or minutes of latitude or longitude, but the difference is only in seconds. From this, you'll get an idea about the use of the smaller units of minutes and seconds in angular measurements. Interesting, right? Now that we know how to read maps, let's take a look at the heat zones of the Earth. As you know, the Earth takes 24 hours for one complete rotation, and the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. As the Earth rotates, there is always day in the eastern part of the globe and there is always night in the western part of the globe, both for 12 hours. Take the prime meridian for reference. As we go 1 degree longitude to the east, 4 minutes are added to the time, and as we go 1 degree longitude to the west, 4 minutes decrease from the time. Cool, right? And now let's go on to the heat zones. We all know the area near the equator receives maximum sunlight. This area is bordered by the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, which are indicated by 23 degrees 30 minutes north and 23 degrees 30 minutes south respectively. This zone receives maximum sunlight and is called the torrid zone. The area between the Tropic of Cancer, 23 degrees 30 minutes north and 66 degrees 30 minutes north, receives pleasant sunlight, and it is called the temperate zone. Similarly, in the southern hemisphere, the area between the Tropic of Capricorn at 23 degrees 30 minutes south and the latitude of 66 degrees 30 minutes north south receives pleasant sunlight. And in the northern hemisphere, the area between latitude 66 degrees 30 minutes north and 90 degrees north receives least amount of sunlight and is called the frigid zone. Similarly, in the southern hemisphere, the area between 66 degrees 30 minutes south and 90 degrees south receives the least amount of sunlight. This is also called the frigid zone. Thus, remember, these are the important circles of latitude. And now let's revise the important latitudes. The most important latitude is the equator at 0 degrees. Then there's the Tropic of Cancer at 23.5 degrees north. Then the Tropic of Capricorn at 23.5 degrees south. Then the Arctic Circle at 66.5 degrees north. Then the Antarctic Circle at 66.5 degrees south. Then there's the North Pole at 90 degrees north. And there's the South Pole at 90 degrees south. So now let's try an activity. Use your brain power. In which direction should an aeroplane fly in order to cover the shortest distance between Kolkata and Chicago? If you want to reach the west coast of US, then it is advisable to fly east from India, crossing Japan and the Pacific to land there. If your travel is to New York or any other eastern coast city of US, it is better to travel via Europe, crossing the Atlantic, Canada and reaching US. So we need to fly west to reach Chicago on the east coast of USA. So now there's an activity. I want you to find the location and the extent of India as a country and comment down below. Comment the answer down below. Now another activity is draw a freehand map of India and its important longitudes and latitudes passing through it and their importance. So there is one very important latitude and one important longitude passing through India. The important latitude is 23.5 degrees north latitude. Yeah, that's right. It's the start for the Tropic of Cancer. And then there is the standard meridian at 82.5 degrees east of the Greenwich Meridian. This meridian passes through the city of Allahabad. It runs through the center of the country. In 1905, this longitude was selected as the meridian to create the standard time. In winter, the Indian Standard Time is 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of Greenwich Mean Time. In summer, this time difference is 4 hours and 30 minutes due to the adjustments made for daylight savings time. India does not use daylight savings time. After India became independent in August 1947, there were 3 separate time zones in India until 1955. As of 2014, the whole of India follows the time set on 82.5 degrees east. So now another activity. Mark on the map of India the following coordinates. 27.1751 degrees north and 78.0421 degrees east. Now which famous landmark of India stands here? Quickly Google the coordinates and mark it on your map. Yes, that's right. The Taj Mahal stands here on this location. So, I'm going to give you an interesting fact before I end the chapter. Treasure Island by Robert Louis Stevenson contains one of the first books for youth with a map. If you know any other books with a map in it, with the latitudes and longitudes, please share the name of the book in the comments below. So, now that you've learned to read maps, you can now search for your own treasure island. So, with this, I'm going to end this lesson or chapter. Friends, hope this video was informative for you and helped you in some way. Please like, share and subscribe. And if you have any doubt or query, comment below and I will try to answer them one by one. So this is your friend Anakin Lalwani signing off. Bye!